Meanwhile, I take a tour of Penang Hill. Why not take the funicular up the hill? Of course, here, it's half roller coaster and half funicular, so hang on tight. The top of Penang Hill offers a surprising respite from the scorching heat, and of course, you get great views of the city below. Sometimes you get lucky and you get to witness a ceremony taking place at the Penang Hill Hindu Temple, one of the oldest Hindu temples here. I come back to Pearly's in time for dinner, and I'm hungry and prepared to enjoy a truly authentic Nyonya meal. What I'm not prepared for is meeting one of Pearly's dinner party guests, James Oslan, former editor of Savour magazine, Top Chef Masters judge, and one of my foodie heroes arrives. And the struggle of not acting like a fool is real, folks. James immediately puts me at ease with his personality. As it turns out, he has plenty of Filipino friends in New York. And so, dinner begins with a reminder from Pearly that in Nyonya cuisine, flavor is king. Plating, it's a distant second.
We are no good with plating because our ancestors always believed that you're going to eat it anyway. Why want to plate it, yeah? And until today, I never learned how to plate my food because I am still very old-fashioned. Just dump it on the table and just serve you rice, and that's how we eat.
Yeah, because Nyonyas are not concerned with Instagram.
Yeah.
Kerabu bihun is a spicy, sweet and sour vermicelli salad meant to stimulate our taste buds.
Yeah, because food.
Pearly stresses that food is medicine, meaning everything you eat must be beneficial to the body.
So this, you can control your weight management. You eat this like maybe 5 times a week.
You see, she said that while looking at me and no one else on this table. I get the message.
The world loves cuddly people.
The dinner is casual, with all of us diners helping her out.